In this lecture, I will explain how to derive the thermodynamics of an extreme relativistic gas, and I will discuss three different procedures. First one is counting the number of microstates from the solution of Schrodinger equation. Second one is counting the number of microstates by calculating the volume of phase space. Third one is by finding the partition function of the system and by using the formulations of canonicalism. All the three procedures will give us identical results for the thermodynamic parameters. So we will discuss one by one. The first problem is from the first chapter of textbook by R.K. Patria, and it is problem number 1.7. It is study the statistical mechanics of an extreme relativistic gas characterized by the single particle energy states epsilon equal to hc by 2l nx square plus ny square plus nz square whole raised to half. Show that the ratio cp by cv in this case is 4 by 3. Actually, in lecture number 3, we did exactly the same calculations for a non-relativistic gas, that is for an ideal gas, classical ideal gas. We did the same thing in lecture number 3. Okay. Using the same procedure, we will do the statistical mechanics of relativistic gas in this problem. Okay. Now, for a single particle, we can invert this relation in order to obtain nx square plus ny square plus nz square is equal to 4 epsilon square l square divided by h square c square. This is obtained by simply squaring this relation and taking this 4 l square and h square c square to the left hand side. Okay. Now, the volume of the container, that is l cube, is equal to v. I can write L square as V raised to 2 by 3. Substitute for this L square, we will get nx square plus ny square plus nz square equal to 4 epsilon square V raised to 2 by 3 divided by h square c square. Let me call this entire quantity as E star. Let me call this entire quantity as not E star, epsilon star. Okay. Now, this is for a single particle. For single particle, there are 3 degrees of freedom. Particle can move in the x direction, y direction or z direction. That is why this equation is nx square plus ny square plus nz square is equal to 4 epsilon square l square by h square c square. For an n particle system, there will be 3n degrees of freedom. And we can write this left hand side as sigma I is equal to 1 to 3n ni square. That is equal to 4 into total energy of the system, let it be capital E, then it becomes 4 capital E square V raised to 2 by 3 divided by H square C square. And we can denote this right hand side as capital E star. For a single particle, we use epsilon for the energy. For an n particle system, total energy can be represented as capital E. Now, the number of microstates is nothing but the number of integral solutions of equation number 2. The number of integral solutions of this equation will give you the number of microstates. And that is nothing but the number of points lying on the surface of a sphere of radii root E star. Because for a single particle, this is actually the equation of a sphere. Nx square plus ny square plus nz square is equal to root epsilon star square. That represents the equation of a sphere in the number space in which the axes are marked as nx, ny and nz respectively. Because in the Cartesian coordinate space, x square plus y square plus z square is equal to r square gives the equation of a sphere of radius r. In a similar manner, in the nx, ny, nz space, nx square plus ny square plus nz square is equal to root epsilon star whole square gives you the equation of a three-dimensional sphere of radius root epsilon star. So this will give you sigma I is equal to 1 to 3 and ni square is equal to capital E star root whole square will give you the equation of a sphere in 3n dimensional space. So the number of microstates is the number of points lying on the surface of the sphere of radii square root of capital E star. And for the detailed explanation of all this, you can refer lecture number 3, because all this we explained in lecture number 3 for classical ideal gas. The only difference is this is a relativistic gas and the energy eigenvalue is different. That is the only difference. All the procedure are exactly same as we did in the case of classical ideal gas. For any clarification, you can watch lecture number 3. Now, since that number, this number of microstates or number of points lying on the surface of a sphere vary very much with respect to the value E star. When we increase the value E star, this number will vary very much. That is, it is a highly irregular function of E star. So we will calculate the number of points lying inside a sphere of radius root E star. All these are exactly similar as we did in the case of classical ideal gas. That is, we will get number of microstates with energy less than E. We will get number of microstates with energy less than E instead of number of microstates with energy equal to E. But in the limit E tends to infinity, that is an asymptotic limit, that both number will be approximately equal and is given by volume of 3n dimensional sphere of radius E star. But when we calculate the number of microstates, they are only the positive integral solutions. So we have to take a factor of 1 by 2 raised to 3n. In a 3-dimensional sphere, if you are considering a number space with the one axis you have nx, the other axis you have ny, other axis you have nz, like this nx, ny, nz, then for getting only positive integral solutions, you have to take only the 1 by 8th of volume of sphere, 1 by 8, only the first octant, okay, to include only positive integral values for nx, ny, nz, you have to include only 1 by 8th of the total volume of sphere. In the case of 3n dimensional sphere, that 1 by 8 will get replaced by 1 by 2 raised to 3n. Okay, if you have one particle, it will be 1 by 8, 1 by 2 cube. If you have n particle, it will be 1 by 2 raised to 3n. And this is the equation for volume of a 3n dimensional sphere. Volume of a 3 dimensional sphere is 4 by 3 pi r cube. If you put n is equal to 1, you will get it as 4 by 3 pi r cube. But for an n particle system, this is volume of 3n dimensional sphere and it is given by pi raised to 3n by 2 divided by 3n by 2 factorial square root E star whole raised to 3n. The derivation of this equation is also in lecture number 3. Now substitute it 1 by 2 raised to 3n, pi raised to 3n by 2, 3n by 2 factorial E star. You can put the value of E star as 4 E square V raised to 2 by 3 by H square C square. Substitute that value for E star, you will get it like this. And you can, this is 4 raised to 3n by 2, that becomes 2 raised to 3n, and that will cancel with this 2 raised to 3n. Remaining is pi E square V raised to 2 by 3 whole raised to 3n by 2 divided by H square C square raised to 3n by 2 into 1 by 3n by 2 factorial. This is the number of microstates. Once we have the number of microstates, entropy is given by k log number of microstates. Substitute for this sigma n E star, that is this quantity. You can take this n to the left hand side. Log a raised to b is b log a. So you will get it as nk log pi E square V raised to 2 by 3 by H square C square whole raised to 3 by 2, not 3n by 2, that n we take it to this side, okay, minus k log 3n by 2 factorial. Why this minus? Because
this 3n by 2 factorial is in the denominator. When you take logarithm, log a by b is log a minus log b. That is why this negative sign. Now Stirling's approximation, log 3n by 2 factorial, I can write it as 3n by 2 log 3n by 2 minus 3n by 2. Okay, this is Stirling's approximation. And rearranging this, I can write s is equal to 3 by 2 nk, that is the last term, minus k multiplied with minus 3n by 2, 3n by 2, 3n by 2 k plus nk log, there is 3n by 2 here, okay, and this is with a negative sign, that will go to the denominator, and 3n is in the denominator, by 2 will go to numerator. So that becomes log 2 pi e square v raised to 2 by 3 by 3n h square c square whole raised to 3 by 2. This is the equation for entropy. Now we can rearrange this, multiply throughout with the 2 and divide with the nk. We give you 2s minus 3nk by 2nk is equal to log 2 pi e square v raised to 2 by 3 by 3n h square c square raised to 3 by 2. Okay. Taking exponential and rearranging, you will get e cube v is equal to 3 n h square c square by 2 pi raised to 3 by 2 e raised to s by n k minus 3 by 2. Then you can write e as 1 by v raised to 1 by 3, 3 n h square c square by 2 pi raised to half e raised to s by 3nk minus 1 by 2. Temperature is partial derivative of E with respect to entropy, keeping N and V constant. So, keep N and V constant, take the derivative with respect to S. This much term is constant, exponential derivative is exponential itself, but function of a function will give you a 1 by 3nk. This much quantity, this quantity is nothing but E. So this is e by 3nk. You can rearrange this to get e is equal to 3nkt. E is equal to 3nkt. Now pressure p is negative of partial derivative of e with respect to v, keeping n and s constant. So take the derivative of this energy with respect to volume, keeping n and s constant. 1 by v raised to 1 by 3 becomes v raised to minus 1 by 3. Derivative is minus 1 by 3 v raised to minus 5 by 3. There is already a negative sign in the definition. So this becomes p is equal to 1 by 3 e by v. Okay. You can write this v raised to minus 5 by 3 as 1 by v raised to 1 by 3 into v. Then you can write it as 1 by 3 e by v. Now, enthalpy H is equal to E plus PV. E is already we obtained as 3nkt. PV is E by 3. So that becomes E plus E by 3. That is 4 by 3 E. And that is 4nkt. Okay. Now, if we have n moles of the gas, then total number of molecules will be n into na. Because one mole contains Avogadro number of molecules. So total number of molecules will be n into na. This n is a number of moles. And na into k, Boltzmann constant becomes the ideal gas constant R. So this becomes E is equal to 3n RT and enthalpy H is equal to 4n RT. Therefore Cv, specific heat at the constant volume, becomes dou E by dou T at constant volume, that is 3nR derivative with respect to T. And specific heat at the constant pressure, Cp is partial derivative of enthalpy with respect to temperature at constant pressure, and that becomes 4nR. And gamma, the ratio of Cp by Cv, that will be 4nR divided by 3nR, you will get it as 4 by 3. 4 by 3. So this is the thermodynamics of relativistic gas derived from the number of microstates. Okay. Here we used the quantum mechanical equations. This is the solution of Schrodinger equation. So using the ideas of quantum mechanics, by counting the number of microstates, we derived the entire thermodynamics of the system. The next question is the same thing, but we are calculating using the idea of phase space. Okay, we are going to derive the entire thermodynamics of a relativistic gas by using the concept of phase space volume. So here we have to use this standard integral. This is again a question in the textbook RK Patria, and it is question number 2.8. Following the method of appendix C, replacing equation C4 by the integral 0 to infinity e raised to minus r squared dr is equal to 2, show that v3n is equal to integral pi I equal to 1 to n 4 pi ri square dri equal to 8 pi r cube raised to n divided by 3n factorial. Using this result, compute the volume of the relevant region of phase space of an extreme relativistic gas. That is, you can use E equal to Pc. P is momentum, C is velocity of light, of n particles moving in three dimensions. Hence, derive expressions for various thermodynamic properties of the system and compare your results with those of problem 1.7. Okay. Now, we have the definition of gamma function as gamma z is equal to integral 0 to infinity e raised to minus t raised to z minus 1 dt. This is defined as z minus 1 factorial. So this integral 0 to infinity e raised to minus r squared dr, that is nothing but gamma 3 or 3 minus 1 factorial. It is 2 factorial and it is 2. That is already given. Now, we know that volume in a 3 dimensional space, volume is proportional to r cube. Okay? Volume of a sphere in 3 dimensional space is 4 by 3 pi r cube. So we can say that in general, volume in a 3n dimensional space is proportional to r raised to 3n. And you can write it equal to some constant into r raised to 3n. So volume of a sphere in 3n dimensional space is v3n is equal to a into r raised to 3n. You can take the differential dv3n is equal to 3n a r raised to 3n minus 1 into dr. Okay, this is the differential volume. dv3n is equal to 3n a r raised to 3n minus 1 into dr. Now, you have already this identity 0 to infinity e raised to minus r squared dr is equal to 2. So, if we consider n such integrals 0 to infinity e raised to minus r1 square dr1 into 0 to infinity e raised to minus r2 square dr2 into etc. And n to 1 is integral 0 to infinity e raised to minus rn square dr. N such integrals will give you 2 into 2 into 2 into n times, that will be simply 2 raised to n. And this side e raised to minus r1 into e raised to minus r2 into e raised to minus rn up to e raised to minus rn, you can write it as e raised to minus sigma I is equal to 1 to n ri. Then product of r1 square r2 square up to rn square. So pi I equal to 1 to n ri square dri, dr1 into dr2 into dr3 into etc. dri. That is equal to 2 raised to n. Or you can write it together as a product, pi I is equal to 1 to n integral 0 to infinity e raised to minus ri square dri, that is equal to 2 raised to n. Call this as equation 1. Okay, so this equation you can write it like this. Now, V3n is already given in the question. V3n is integral. N such integrals pi I is equal to 1 to n 4 pi ri square dr. Okay, that integral we will consider pi I is equal to 1 to n 4 pi ri square dri. And there is one condition, this ri, the value restricted between 0 and capital R. The upper limit of this ri is capital R. When we derived the expression in the case of classical ideal gas. This is something like sigma equal to 1 to 3n ri square, 1 to 3n ri square less than or equal to r square, and this is now sigma equal to 1 to n ri less than or equal to capital R. Now v3n we can all also write it as integral dv3n. dv is differential of v3n, so integrating this differential you will get v3n. But dv3n, we already have an expression 3na r raised to 3n minus 1 dr. Substituting that, we will get v3n as integral 3na r raised to 3n minus 1 dr. But dv3n is nothing but sigma I is equal to 1 to n 4 pi ri square dri. Because in a three-dimensional space, dv3, dv3 you can write it as, in Cartesian you can write it as dx1 into dx2 into dx3. In spherical polar you can write it as 4 pi r square dr. In spherical polar you can write it as 4 pi r square dr. So if you have n such integrals, then you can write it as sigma I is equal to 1 to n 4 pi ri square dri. This is dv3n. Therefore, equation 1, this is equation 1, this I can write it as integral 0 to infinity, integral 0 to infinity, e raised to minus r, e raised to minus, this is sigma equal to 1 to n ri, this is r, e raised to minus r, 4 pi raised to minus n, 4 pi raised to minus n, because this pi I equal to 1 to n 4 pi ri square dri. This n times, each time you will get a 4 pi, so that will give you a 4 pi raised to n that you can take outside, and that will go to the left hand side. In the denominator that becomes 4 pi raised to minus n dv3n, dv3n, this quantity. Okay, so you substituted for this quantity, pi I is equal to 1 to n integral 0 to infinity ri square dri becomes 4 pi raised to minus n dv3n. The right hand side is 2 raised to n. Okay. Now this is integral 0 to infinity e raised to minus r dv3n. dv3n is 3na, 3na r raised to 3n minus 1 dr. This 4 pi raised to minus n go to the other side, and that becomes 4 pi raised to n. There is already a 2 raised to n. So that becomes 8 pi raised to n. Now, this left hand side is 3na is constant. 3na is constant. Remaining is gamma function. 0 to infinity e raised to minus r, r raised to 3n minus 1 dr. This is nothing but 3 gamma 3n or 3n minus 1 factorial. Gamma 3n or 3n minus 1 factorial. So, I can write it as A equal to 8 pi raised to n divided by 3n gamma 3n. What is 3n gamma 3n? We have the identity z gamma z as gamma z plus 1 or z factorial. Therefore, 3n gamma 3n is 3n factorial. So, the value of A is 8 pi raised to n divided by 3n factorial. Therefore, volume of 3n dimensional sphere is v3n is equal to a into r raised to 3n, that becomes 8 pi r cube raised to n divided by 3n factorial. If we have n is equal to 1, that is a 3 dimensional sphere, have volume 8 pi r cube divided by 3 factorial, that is 4 by 3 pi r cube. Okay, so this is a famous relation, the volume of 3 dimensional sphere, it is 4 by 3 pi r cube, and volume of a 3n dimensional sphere is 8 pi r cube raised to n divided by 3n factorial. Now what is volume of phase space? Volume of phase space is, if we have 3n degrees of freedom, we will have 3n coordinates. So the differentials are dq1, dq2, etc., dq3n integral. So there will be 3n such integrals. Again, there will be 3n such momenta, dp1, dp2, etc., dp3n. Again, 3n integrals. Okay, so total 6n integrals will be there. But integral dq1 dq2 dq3 will give you v. Then dq4 dq5 dq6 will give you another v. So there will be such n such v's. So that will give you v raised to n. V raised to n. So the integrating over the entire coordinates will be v raised to n. Remaining is integration over the momenta, integral, integral, etc. Pi I is equal to 1 to 3n dpi. You can convert this to spherical polar coordinates, then it will be pi I is equal to 1 to n. There will be n integrals, 4 pi pi square dpi. When you convert a Cartesian integral to a spherical polar integral, three variables reduces to a single variable r. Okay, so here this 3n integrals becomes n integrals, pi I is equal to 1 to n, 4 pi pi square dpi. But we already know the answer for this integral, and that is nothing but 8 pi r cube raised to n by 3n factorial. Instead of r, you have p. So it is 8 pi p cube raised to n divided by 3n factorial. Now, volume of phase space is the product of volume of momentum space and volume of coordinate space. Volume of coordinate space is v raised to n, and volume of momentum space is 8 pi p cube divided by 3n factorial. Now, for a relativistic gas, the total energy E is equal to pc, where p is the total momentum and c is the velocity of light. So, p, we can write it as E by c. Therefore, this volume becomes 8 pi v E cube by c cube raised to n into 1 by 3n factorial. This is volume of phase space. Once we have volume of phase space, the number of microstates is given by volume divided by the fundamental volume of phase space. That is, for a three, for a system having 3n degrees of freedom, it is h raised to 3n, where h is Planck's constant. The volume for a particular microstate, the fundamental volume for a particular microstate is h for a system of 1 degree of freedom. For a system of 3n degree of freedom, it is h raised to 3n. The total volume of the phase space divided by h raised to 3n will give you number of microstates. And there is a factor of 1 by n factorial, and that is related to the indistinguishable nature of the particles that we discussed in previous lectures. Okay, now you substitute all these quantities, number of microstates becomes 8 pi v e cube divided by h cube c cube whole raised to n into 1 by 3n factorial, that is already there, and this 1 by n factorial. This is the number of microstates for a system of n indistinguishable particles. Therefore, we got omega. Now, entropy S is k log omega, k log omega. If you take the logarithm of this quantity, this n will come to this side. So, this becomes nk log 8 pi v e cube divided by h cube c cube. And this quantity, 1 by 3n factorial, it is minus k log 3n factorial. And this is 1 by n factorial, that becomes minus k log n factorial. For the last two terms, you can apply Stirling's approximation. First term is nk log 8 pi v e cube divided by h cube c cube minus log 3n factorial is 3n log 3n minus 3n. When you multiply it with this minus k, you will get minus 3nk log 3n plus 3nk, and the last term becomes minus nk log n plus nk. So that becomes s is equal to 4nk, 4nk plus nk log 8 pi v e cube divided by h cube c cube into this. You can take this 3 to a log b is log b raised to a, so this becomes log 3n raised to 3. 3 raised to 3 is 27, and n raised to 3 is n cube. That is this 1 by 27 n cube. And from here, you will get a 1 by n. Okay. So, final equation for entropy is S is equal to 4nk. You can write it in the inverse form by putting a negative sign here. Minus nk log to take the inverse of this quantity. You can write n divided by 8 pi v separately. The remaining is hc divided by e by 3n the whole cube. Actually, this e by 3n I can replace with the kt, because for a relativistic gas, total energy E is equal to 3n kt. So this will become minus mk log n by 8 pi v hc by kt whole cube. Because when we deal with the partition function in the next problem, the entropy relation will be something like that. Okay. So in order to compare these two relations, you keep this in mind. E by 3n is actually kt. Okay. Now we will keep it as such. So entropy is 4nk minus nk log n by 8 pi v hc by e by 3n whole cube. Once we have entropy, reciprocal of absolute temperature 1 by T is dou S by dou E at constant NV, and the first term 4nk derivative is with respect to the variable E, that will be 0. And for the second term, there is an E inside logarithm, so there is a minus nk outside, into logarithm derivative is 1 divided by that function into function of a function, n by 8 pi v hc 3n whole cube, e raised to minus 3. Derivative is minus 3 e raised to minus 4. This minus and this minus becomes plus, and there is a 3 and this nk, 3nk. This quantity and this quantity will cancel, and there will be a 1 by e. So that becomes 3nk divided by e. So using this expression, you can write e is equal to 3nkt. E is equal to 3nkt. The same expression we obtained using the previous method also. Now, you can write s by nk minus 4 is equal to minus log n by 8 pi v hc by e by 3n the whole cube from this expression of entropy. Then this minus sign you can include in the logarithm. Then that becomes logarithm of 8 pi v divided by n, reciprocal of this quantity, e by 3n hc the whole cube. Then you can find E as a function of S. So E is equal to n by 8 pi v whole raised to 1 by 3, 3n hc into E raised to S by 3nk minus 4 by 3. Once we have E as a function of S, V and N, we can calculate the partial derivative of E with respect to V, keeping N and S constant. And that will give you pressure. P is equal to minus dou E by dou V at a constant N and S. And once, when you take the derivative, V raised to minus 1 by 3, derivative is minus 1 by 3 into V raised to minus 5 by 3. And minus, and this minus becomes plus, and that will give you 1 by 3 V into E. 1 by 3 V into E. So, you can write PV is equal to E by 3, PV is equal to E by 3. Therefore, enthalpy, H is equal to E plus PV, that becomes 4 by 3 E, and it is 4 NKT. These are exactly the same results we obtained from the earlier procedure also. Now CV, it is dou E by dou T at constant volume, it becomes 3nk. CP is dou H by dou T at constant pressure, it is 4nk. And gamma, the ratio of specific heat will be 4 by 3. So all the results are identical with the results obtained using the previous method. All these equations are exactly the same. Okay, now we will discuss another method.
This is from chapter number 3 of RK Patria textbook, 3.15. Show that the partition function Q and Vt of an extreme relativistic gas consisting of n monoatomic molecules with energy momentum relationship E equal to Pc, c being the speed of light, is given by Qn of Vt is 1 by n factorial into 8 pi v kt by hc the whole cube all raised to n. Study the thermodynamics of the system, checking in particular that PV is U by 3, U by N is 3kT and gamma is 4kT. Okay. So we already calculated all these using two different approaches, and this is the third approach, and this is the approach of canonical ensemble. Here we will calculate first the single particle partition function. Then using that, we will calculate the n particle partition function. From the partition function, we can derive the entire thermodynamics. So, single particle partition function, we can either integrate over all energy values e raised to minus beta e, or you can integrate over the volume of phase space e raised to minus beta I d omega, but you have to divide it with a fundamental volume of phase space, and for a single particle there will be 3 degree of freedom and that quantity is h cube. So this is the definition of partition function for a continuous energy, that will be a integral e raised to minus beta I de, or you can write it as integral e raised to minus beta I into d omega by h cube. The d omega is the volume element of phase space, and this integration is over the volume of phase space, and this integration is over all the energy values. We will calculate partition function using this second equation, that is q1 beta is equal to 1 by h cube into integral e raised to minus beta into energy is pc for an extreme relativistic gas. D omega is actually dqi dpi. Here there will be actually six integrals, three for the position coordinates dq1, dq2, dq3, and three for momentum dp1, dp2, dp3. But the integration over volume will give you total volume of the container V. So, and dp1, dp2, dp3, volume element you can write it in spherical polar coordinates, and that becomes 4 pi p square dp. And this p will vary from 0 to infinity. So the six integrals now reduced into a single integral. Three integrals will contribute a volume V, and two integrals will contribute a 4 pi. Okay. So the finally you will get it as 1 by h cube integral 0 to infinity e raised to minus pc by kt V into 4 pi p square V. 4 pi V will come outside. 4 pi V divided by h cube integral 0 to infinity e raised to minus pc by kt p square V. Substitute pc by kt as y, then dp will be kt by c into dy. Then q1 of beta is 4 pi v by h cube integral 0 to infinity. There will not be any change in limits. As p tends to 0, y tends to 0. As p tends to infinity, y tends to infinity. 0 to infinity e raised to minus y. P square becomes k square t square by c square into y square. Dp becomes kt by c into dy. So kt by c whole cube will come outside. Remaining is integral 0 to infinity e raised to minus y square dy. This is nothing but gamma 3. Gamma 3 is 2 factorial, or it is 2. So that makes it 8 pi v kt by c the whole cube. This is single particle partition function. And since these are indistinguishable particles, the n particle partition function is given by 1 by n factorial into single particle partition function raised to n. That will give 1 by n factorial 8 pi v kt by hc whole cube all raised to n. Okay. Now, once we have the partition function, we can calculate Helmholtz free energy. A is equal to minus kt log q. In the formulation of canonical ensemble, once we have the partition function, the next step is to calculate Helmholtz free energy. From Helmholtz free energy, we can calculate entropy, temperature, pressure, etc. So Helmholtz free energy A is minus kt log qn, and that becomes minus kt log qn is 8 pi v kt by hc whole cube raised to n divided by n factorial. This n will come to this side. This is minus n kt log 8 pi v into kt by hc the whole cube. And this log a by b is log a minus log b, and there is already a negative sign here, so that becomes plus kt log n factorial. Again, using Stirling's approximation, log n factorial you can write it as n log n minus n, and that makes this last two times kt n log n minus n kt. This first time this negative sign can be absorbed into the log, and you can write it inverse logarithm of 1 by 8 pi v hc by kt whole. So a is equal to nkt log. This nkt you can take common from first two times, and there is a log n here, that makes it log n by 8 pi v hc by kt whole cube minus this nkt. This is Helmholtz free energy. Once we have Helmholtz free energy, we can calculate entropy as minus dou A by dou T at a constant N and B. So take derivative with respect to temperature. The first you have to apply product rule for this term. Keep logarithm of this quantity constant, derivative of NKT will give you NK.
there is already a negative sign in the definition. Then keep nkt constant, logarithm of a function, derivative is 1 divided by that function. But now the derivative is with respect to temperature, so you have to apply function of a function. Derivative of this term with respect to temperature, that will give you n by 8 pi v h by kt whole cube, 1 by t cube, derivative is minus 3 t raised to minus 4. This last term, derivative is nk. Okay, this is actually minus nk, but there is already a negative sign in the definition. So that becomes plus nk. And this second term, you can cancel all the terms and you will get it as 3 nkt. Okay, 3 nt also will cancel. So remaining it will be plus 3 nk. You have a plus nk in the last term. So total there will be 4 mk. And the first term is minus nk log n by 8 pi v hc by kt whole cube. This is the expression for entropy. Now, internal energy U is A plus Ts. This is the equation for A plus T into S. That will give you these two terms. And you add these two, the first and the third term will cancel. Minus nkt plus 4 nkt will give you 3 nkt. So, internal energy of the system is 3 nkt. The same expression that we obtained from the earlier two treatment. Pressure is minus dou A by dou V at constant n and t. That will give you minus nkt into logarithm. Derivative is 1 divided by that quantity. Derivative is with respect to V. That will give you n by 8 by hc by kt whole cube into 1 by V. Derivative is minus 1 by V square. That is P is equal to this negative and this negative becomes positive. Nkt divided by V. All other terms will cancel. So I can write it as PV is equal to nkt. PV is equal to nkt. Now enthalpy H is equal to U plus PV. U is 3 nkt plus PV is nkt. So it will be 4 nkt. CV is dou U by dou T at a constant volume. That is 3 nk. CP is dou H by dou T at a constant pressure. That is 4 nk. Gamma is the ratio of Cp and Cv, that will give me 4 by 3. Okay? All the results are exactly same that we obtained from the earlier two treatment. So here I discussed, in this lecture I discussed three different methods in order to derive the thermodynamics of extreme relativistic gas. Okay? The first method is counting number of microstates from the knowledge of the energy eigenvalue. So this is quantum mechanical treatment. The next one is counting the number of microstates from the idea of phase space. Okay. Then the third one is using partition function. That is the idea of canonical ensemble. And it is clear that the third treatment is simple if we compare all the three methods. Okay. So thank you.